here, also known as Boer Brother 16. I'm here to talk to you about a 1961 Snowbug snowmobile. The Snowbug snowmobiles were built in Sudbury, Ontario by a gentleman named Howard Schrader. Howard was an enthusiast of all things related to snowmobiles. He was a mechanic, a motorcycle dealer. Howard was quite the inventor and always willing to try different things. In 1957, he began production of the Snowbug snowmobile, and production continued until 1977. Snowbug snowmobiles were first powered by West Bend engines. They weren't all that powerful, and Howard, being the inventor, was looking for something that he could use that was relatively cheap. So, using his motorcycle knowledge, he turned to motorcycle engines. He bought Villiers engines from England and attempted to use them in the 1960 and 61 Snowbug models. The Villiers motorcycle engines were used in a number of motorcycles, including Villiers, Excelsior, and Norton, just to name a few. Motorcycle engines generally are used in warm conditions, and unfortunately, what we have are brutal Canadian winters. So the engines actually did break down quite frequently. They would heat up and then would cool down to minus 30 and actually would seize the engine. Mr. Schrader chose other engines such as Hirth, Sachs, and Kohler to power his sleds. This is an all-aluminum chassis with a 26-inch rubber track with aluminum cleats, slider suspension. The pogo stick steering has springs both top and bottom, and actually traveled up and down as you went over rough snow conditions. It has a half-moon car-like steering wheel. The sled also has clutch pedal, a gas pedal, no brakes, hang on. And in 1961, supposedly, you could order these sleds with an electric start. This particular sled is powered by a 173cc two-stroke Mark IIL engine. It has taken 6 years to complete the restoration of this snowmobile to get it to the point that it is ready to run on the snow. And hopefully today we'll see that happen. Villiers engine parts are available in the UK. I had the good fortune of meeting a gentleman in Orangeville from Proformance Cycle who rebuilt this engine for me. Unfortunately, we did not get to the point where we got it started and running. That took several years later, help from Old Vintage Cranks and more recently Don Tuttle. So thank you all for that help. This sled was originally obtained from Corey Crozier in Renfrew, Ontario. I don't have a lot of the provenance before Corey got it, but it was sold to my good friend Bill Ross, who has a number of Snowbug snowmobiles. Bill didn't believe he would be able to restore this sled, so he gave me the opportunity to be the next owner. And having grown up in Terrace Bay in the wilderness, I saw this type of sled in use by a school chum, Dean McLeod, and I was all googly-eyed. Wow, did I ever want to own one of these sleds? And today, I do. So this video hopefully will go properly and we'll get this sled out on the snow. We'll see how she runs. No guarantees. There you have it, folks. The 1961 Snowbug snowmobile out on its inaugural voyage after many years of sitting idle. What a fun little sled to ride. I really need to learn how to shift gears, Charlie. It is important that we demonstrate how these old snowmobiles actually work and how their innovative technology shapes what we're riding today. What a fun thing to do, to ride an antique sled. The antique snowmobile hobby is filled with wonderful people who are always there to help out. I'd like to thank Roger Labonte for making me an exact replica, according to the patent, ski. So there are folks out there that are always willing to help. And thank you very much, Roger. For more information on the Snowbug snowmobile, a gentleman by the name of Yvonne Gauthier produced a wonderful book called Snowbugs and is available at numerous places in Canada and the US. Take care, everyone. Stay safe and get out and have some fun.